Therefore, blessed follow her to fight against the children of Emma that didst not call us to go with thee. We will the thine house upon thee with fire. Said unto them, I am mighty power at great strife with the children of Ammon, and when I called you, ye delivered me not out of them. And when I saw that ye delivered me not, I put my life in my hands and passed over against the children. And wherefore then are ye come unto me this day to fight against me? And yet have answered to better all the men of Gilead, and fought with Ephraim, and the men of Gilead smote Ephraim, because they said, ye Gileadites are fugitives of Ephraim among thee. I said among the Manassites, and the Gileadites took the passages of Jordan before the Ephraimites, and it was so that when those Ephraimites which were escaped said, let me go over that the men of Gilead said unto him, said they unto him, say much in the land. He said, in the land, for he told not train to pronounce it right. They took him and slew him at the precipice of Jordan, and there fell at that time of the Ephraimites 42,000, and half of the Israelites years had died, Bethabara. Then we of thy hand was buried, and one of the cities of Bethlehem. And after him is son of Bethlehem, of Israel, and he had to be sons and to be daughters whom he sent abroad and took him to be daughters from abroad for his sons. And he dubbed Israel. Then long years had died in sun and was buried at Bethlehem, and after him he was sad, but all might dubbed Israel, and he dubbed Israel 10 years, and he was sad, but all might died and was buried in it. In the country of Hezbollah, and after him Adonijah, son of Shelemiah, Yehoshua, might dubbed Israel, and he and 30 nephews, Jethro, Bod, Rephor, and Dan, Ashdod, and he dubbed Israel 8 years, and Ephron, the son of Shillem, taught by Esau. In the land of Ephraim, amid the mountains, me a manly sight, sinned in such a chapter 13, and the children Israel did he love, and in the sight of the Lord and the Lord delivered them into the hand of the Philistines 40 years, and there was a certain man of Zorah, the family of the Danite, whose name was Manoah, and his wife was Merod, and Merod, and the angel of the to the woman and said unto
Let her
Red wine or strong drink, glory to me, O sweet Saviour. I commanded her, let her observe, and may the law ever to be a challenge. The Lord, I pray thee, let us take thee on to which and has made red me a head for thee and be a challenge. The Lord said unto me, detain me, I will not eat of thy bread, and this thou wilt offer other offering, thou must offer it unto the Lord. For Nabal knew not that he was an angel of the Lord, and Nabal was said unto the angel of the Lord, is thy name such when thy sayings come to pass? We may do thee other and the angel of the Lord said unto him, why askest thou thus after my name? See, and it is the truth, so may thou a tortured with a meat offering, and offered it upon a rock unto the Lord. And the angel did wondrously, and Nabal and his wife looked on, for it came to pass when the flame went up the Lord had gone from off the altar, that the angel of the Lord ascended in the flame of the altar, and Nabal and his wife looked on it and fell on their faces to the ground. But the angel of the Lord did no more appear to Nabal, and to his wife, and Nabal knew that he was an angel of the Lord. And Nabal said unto his wife, we can surely die, because we have seen God. But his wife said unto him, if the Lord were pleased to kill us, he would not have received a burnt offering and a meat offering at our hands, neither would he have slain us all these sins, nor would that at his time have told us such sins as he and the woman bear us on, and told his names and son, and the child grew, and the Lord blessed him, and the Spirit of the Lord began to move him at times in the camp and between the row and tails in Benjamin's chapter 14. And Samson went down to Timnath, and saw a woman in Timnath of the daughter heard of Philistines, and he came up and told his father and his mother, and said, "I have seen a woman in Tim that heard of Philistines, now therefore bid her for me to wife, and his father and his mother said unto him, "Is there never a woman among thy daughters and thy brethren, or among all thy people, that thou goest to take a wife?" But the uncircumcised Philistines and Samson said unto his father, "Bid her for me, for she pleaseth me well." But his father and his mother knew not that it was of the Lord that he sought an occasion against the Philistines. For at that time the Philistines had dominion over Israel. Then went Samson down, and his father and his mother to Timnath, and to the vineyards of Timnath, and behold, a young lion roared against him, and the Spirit of the Lord came mightily upon him, and he rent him as he would have rent a kid, and he had not him in his hand. But he told not his father or his mother what he had done, and he went down and talked with the woman, and she pleased Samson well. And after a time he returned to take her, and he turned aside to see the carcass of the lion, and behold, there was a swarm on knees and honey in the carcass of the lion. And he took thereof in his hands, and went home it did, and came to his father and mother, and he bathed them, and they did eat, but he told not them that he had taken the honey out of the carcass of the lion. So his father went down unto the woman, and Samson made there a feast, for so used the young men to do. And it came to pass when they saw him that they brought the companions to be with him. And Samson said unto them, "I will now put forth a riddle unto you. If ye can certainly declare it me, within the 7 days of the feast, and find it out, then I will give you 30 cheeks and 30 shakes of barley." But if ye can not declare it me, then can ye give me 30 cheeks and 30 shakes?
house, books, and songs. Life was vision to his companion, whom he had used as his friend. In Vintage, his chapter 15, but it came to pass within a while after in the time of which our Lord set hands on his soft of his life with a kid, and he said, I will go into my wife into the chamber, but her father would not suffer him to go in, and her father said, I verily hope that thou hadst taught her we hate taught her. Therefore I bade her to thy companion, is not her younger sister fairer? Can she take her? I pray thee instead of her, and sends on dead concern in them. Now shall I be more blameless, and to fill a steam so I do them a displeasure, and sense of lent and top 300 foxes, and took fire brands and turned tail to tail, and put a firebrand in the midst between two tails, and when he had set the brands on fire, he let them go into the stand in for the Philistines, and burnt up both the fox and also the stand, did for with the vineyards and all which sent the Philistines fish and hay and herbs and some tars on in law, and the tin might be taught he had taken his life and vision companion and the Philistines came up and burnt her and her father with fire, and Samson's head unto them. Yet will I be avenged of you, and after that I will see them. and he smoked and shit and toy with a break slaughter. And he went down and went in the top of the rope eaten. And the Philistines went up and ditched into the and spread hands and said, "We high and the men unto the said, why are ye come up against us?" And they answered to bind them.
And took it and flew. A thousand
Oh. me bound to afflict me, and then some said unto her, if they bind me with session, bring with that were measured right, and shall I be weak and be as a mortal man, and the Lord such a Philistine brought up to her session, bring with which had not been bright, and she bound him with them all there were men lying in wait abide then with her in the chamber, and she said unto him, the Philistines be upon these, and so then he brake the withs as a thread of tow is broke, and when it touches the fire, so his strength was but low, and Delilah said unto them, some bishop, thou hast mocked me and told me lies. Now tell me, I pray thee, wherewith thou mightest be bound. And he said unto her, if they bind me fast with new ropes that measure of your bind, then shall I be weak and be as a mortal man. Delilah therefore took two ropes and bound him therewith, and said unto him, the Philistines be upon thee. And so then there were liars in wait abide them in the chamber, and he brake them from off his arms like a thread, and Delilah said unto Samson, hitherto thou hast mocked me and told me lies, tell me wherewith thou mightest be bound. And he said unto her, if thou leavest the session locks on my head with the weapon, she fastened it with the pin, and said unto him, the Philistines be upon thee. Then saw them he awaked out of his sleep, and went away with the pin, and the beam, and with the weapon. She said unto him, how canst thou say, I was beat when thine heart is not with me? Thou hast mocked me these three times, and hast not told me wherein thy great strength lieth. And it came to pass, when she pressed him daily with her words and urged him so that she so was next unto death, that he told her all his heart, and said unto her, there hath not come a razor upon mine head, for I have been a messer right unto God from my mother's womb. If I be chosen, then my strength will go from me, and I shall become weak and and be like any of them, and when Delilah saw that he had told her all his heart, she sent and told for the Lord's and the Philistines, saying, come up his once, for he hath slew me all his heart, and the Lord's and the Philistines came up unto her and brought money in their hand, and she made him sleep up on her knees, and she told for a man, and she tossed him to chain of brass, and unlocked such his head, and she began to afflict him, and his strength fled from him, and she said, the Philistines be upon thee, Samson, and he awoke out of his sleep, and said, I will go out as at other times before, and shake myself, and he wist not that the Lord was departed from him, but the Philistines took him and bought out his eyes and brought him down to Gaza, and bound him with fetters of brass, and he did grind in the brazen house. How may it the hair on his head began to grow again after he was shaved, and the Lord's and the Philistines that turned them to measure for to offer a great sacrifice unto Nabon their God, and to rejoice, for they said, our God hath delivered Samson our enemy into our hand. And when the people saw him, they praised their God, for they said, our God hath delivered into our hands our enemy, and the destroyer of our country, which slew many of us. And it came to pass, when their hearts were merry, that they said, call for Samson, that he may make a sport. And they told for Samson out of the prison house, and he made them sport, and they set him between the pillars. And Samson said unto the lad that held him by the hand, suffer me that I may feel the pillars whereupon the house stand this, that I may weep upon them. Now the house was full of men and women, and all the lords of the Philistines were there, and there were upon the roof about 3,000 men and women that beheld when Samson made sport, and Samson told up to the Lord and said, O Lord God, remember me, I pray thee, and strengthen me, I pray thee, O leave his words, O God, that I may be at once again. lost, painful light to eyes. Exams are total doctor to mid the day work upon which the house tolls and for which it was for love. A sea on which it rides, and the moon be a which is. Left hands and arms and let me die with the frameless team's end. People chain, self with all his might, and the house fell upon the Lord's head. Upon all the deep bombs that were there in Zoltan, and which he slew at his death, were more than they which he slew. In his life, and his brethren, and all the house of his father came down then, and took him and brought him up and buried him between Zora and Echtay, all in the buried and place of Maynola. His father and he touched Israel 20 years. Simple touched his shadows and the deep, and there was a man of Monte Free, whose name was my God. He said unto his mother, be well, on the branch that comes of sin, the that were taken from the about, which out of sense can state the star. Also in mine ears behold the sinner is with me. I taught it at his mother said, blessed be Allah, the Lord my son, and when he had restored me, let not a drop that comes on similar to his mother, his mother's advice, and so weeded the gate, took the sinner up to the Lord from my hand, for my son to make a grave of in it, and the mountain in it now. Therefore I will restore it unto thee, yet he restored the money unto his mother, and his mother talked to the drop that comes of silver and made there.
founder who made Terra.
Pray Sun in it and the mountain in it and say we're in the house. As might and the men might head and house as gods and made them a sun and terra. Sin and consecrated one of his sons who became history's in those days there was no divinity on the treasury man did set which was right in his own eyes and there was a
to
high priest sin been purchased, but to late he did so stay. There was no sin in Israel, and did so stay stopped right up. God then might sought them an inheritance to dwell in for unto that day all their inheritance had not fallen unto them among the tribes of Israel, and the children of the descendants of their family find men from their coasts, men of the world from Zorah and from Caleb and to search it and face it unto them, go search the land whose went they came to Mount Ephraim to the house of there when they were by the house of Micah, they knew the voice of the young man, Dalilah, and Hatem did hit him and said, him to grow. Beat it through and what make it tall in his lathe and what had tall. He ran, he led on to and God, and God he led. Hired me and I am his priest and said unto him that calls the weak raise me of God that we may know as to our way which we departed and came to lie it and hold a key on that word wherein all faith dwelt there was after the man the old God I know me on dry up and sit your and there was no man just right in the land that might both men to chain in and meet him and they were far from God. bread from heaven.
To them look, say ye and pray. Head aright, that we may go up against them, for we had seen the land and behold it.
Golden, for ye to be not lost from to go and to them
to possess
the lands. When ye go, ye can come unto the kingdom. Set your end to the large land, for God has that is in the earth, and there went from heaven the family of God, and right out of Zorah, and out of Eshtaol, it come from men appointed with
Zorah, and they went up and pitched in to cast in
a rim into nowhere, for they told that place lay to Bethlehem unto his name. Behold, it is behind to cast in a rim, and they cast in unto Ephraim, and came unto the house of my father, and heard the five men that went to spy out the country of Lyish, and said unto their brethren, do ye look at their visit peace? How sudden a fall and terror, sin and abrasion in it, and the molten image now therefore comes in the world. Ye have to do, and Satan his servant, and came to the house of the young men, the Levite even unto the house of Micah, and the root of Shem, and the 600 men appointed with their weapons, as for which were unconscious dread of them, told by the entering of the gate, and the five men had went to spy out the land, went up and came in his hand, and took the brazen image, and the ephod, and the teraphim, and the molten image, and the priest stood in the entering of the gate with the 600 men that were appointed with weapons of war, and he went in to Micah's house and fetched the charged image, the ephod, and the teraphim, and the molten image, and the priest of
said unto him, Hold thy peace, lay thine hand upon thy mouth, and go with us, and be to us a father and a priest. Is it better for me to be a priest unto the house of the man, or that shall be a priest unto a tribe and a family in Israel? And the priest's heart was gladdened. He took the ephod and the teraphim and the branch of image and went in amidst of the people, so Satan then departed and brought the little ones and the cattle and the carried before them. And when they were all away from the house, a light of the men that were in the house was there. To my God's house were that stood to Bethel, and overtook the children of Dan. And they cried unto the children of Dan, and they turned their faces and said unto my God, hey, Lord, see that thou comest with such a company. And he said, ye have taken away my gods, which I made, and the priest, and ye are gone away. And what have I more, and what is this that ye say unto me, what children of Dan said unto him, Let not thy voice be heard among us, lest every fellow run upon thee and thou lose thy life with the lives of thy household. And the children of Dan went their way, and when Micah saw that they were too strong for him, he turned and went back unto his house. And they took the things which Micah had made, and the priest which he had, and came unto Elijah, unto the people that were at Twilight, and sit your and they smote them with the head of the sword, and burnt the city with fire, and there was no pillager be, cause it was far from Zidon, and they had no business with any man, and it was in the valley that lieth by Bethrehab, and they built a city and dwelt therein, and they told the name of the city. The first and the ancient bread of the set of the brazen image and dharma. Chanta sabas the chanta sabas mama seti and his sons were priests to the tribe of them until the day of the captivity of the land and they set them up like a brazen image which he made all the times at the house of God was in silence in Judges chapter 19 and it came to pass in those days when there was no hill in Israel that there was a certain Levite sojourning on the side of Mount Ephraim to talk to him upon the Bible out of this we can do the ancient of the mind laid the whore against him and went away from him unto her father's house to this we can do the and was there for so much, and her husband arose and went after her to speak friendly unto her and to bring her a man to live his alone with him and not above a vessel. And she brought him into her father's house. And when the father's job and love saw him, he rejoiced to meet him and his father in all the man's father. The retained him, and he abode with him 3 days, so they did eat and drink and lodged there. And it came to pass on the 4th day when they arose early in the morning, that he rose up to depart. And the man's father said unto his son-in-law, comfort thine heart with a morsel of bread, and afterward go your way, and they sat down, and did eat and drink both of them to better for God. And the father had said unto the man, be content, I pray thee, and tarry all night, and let thine heart be merry. And when the man rose up to depart, his father-in-law lodged him. Therefore he lodged there a man, and he arose early in the morning on the 5th day to depart. And the man's father said, comfort thine heart, I pray thee, and they tarried until after moon. And they did eat both of them, and when the man rose up to depart, he and his dog by them, and his son, his father-in-law, the man's father said unto him, behold, now the day draweth toward evening, I pray you tarry all night. grow as to an end love.
Peace at thine heart may be merry, and tomorrow bid you early on your way that thou mayest go home. But the man would not tarry, that night but he rose again, departed and came over against Venus, which is Jerusalem. And there were witches to Essos, and goatees concubine, also was witches. And when they were by Pebas, the day was far spent, and the serjeant said unto his master, come I, pray thee, and let us turn in into his city. And love it, and his master said unto him, we will not turn aside hither into the city yard. A stranger that is children of his. Really, we will dazzle her to him. Be and he said unto his son, look, come and let us draw near to one of his place, us to love all night in Pibia or in Rhaema.
And they danced on and went their way,
and the sun went down upon them when they were by Pibia, which turned aside hither to go in and to love him in the end. When he went in, he sat him down in a street. Was it deed, for there was no man that took them into his house to love him? And behold, there came an old man from his work out of the field that he was also
a mighty free, a mighty soldier.
Didn't it be about the men, but the place where the might and when he had lifted up his eyes, he saw a wayfaring man in
the street opposite he and the old man.
Said with the lowest tall and went the
next tall and he said unto